Alright folks, today I'm gonna show you how to grill these amazing looking flank steak rolls. Stay tuned. It's time to grill. I usually post video recipes with a large amount of ingredients. So today it's pretty easy. The exact number of ingredients can be counted on two fingers. First one is an American beef flank steak from one of my favorite online butchery, gourmetfleisch.de. I will put a link into the video description so you can check it out. And second is a barbecue wrap. So that's all we need for today. Of course, we need a sharp knife so we can cut away some smaller parts of the steaks, but that's all we have to do here. My viewers who are watching regularly already know that I have a cooperation with Spice Bar, which is a local spice dealer from Berlin, and they have these small packages, and that's pretty interesting. Sometimes you have recipes where you only need a small amount or just want to try something out. So these are perfect for that one. You can buy them in their online store for a lot of their rubs and spices. Of course, there will be a link in the video description as well, so you can check it out. They have amazing peppers, and of course, they produce the one and only 0815 barbecue rub selection. You might have seen that in my videos as well. So this one is called Rauchige Drecksau, which means like smoky pork or something like that. And it's the goal to have the rub almost everywhere. And then we take the flank steak and roll it this way. Then you will need some skewers. I decided to have these Broil King metal double skewers. They are pretty perfect for that kind of recipe because they keep the flank steak roll completely fixed, and the double skewers also helps that if you want to turn your steak on the grill, you are able to turn it with the meat, not only the skewers inside the meat. A lot of people might have realized that. If you don't have double skewers, of course you can take two single skewers and just use it the same way. This might work. Then sharp knife and cut the flank steak rolls into approximately the same size than the other. So that's the goal. Let's see how we did. That's the first one. That's the second one. Yeah, almost the same. So it doesn't have to be perfect, but in this case they look pretty good. Of course, if you want to add stuffing to your flank steak, like spinach leaves or leek leaves or prosciutto, feel free to use this. This is a basic version and I don't want to add anything more. I have already made a video with a flank steak roast. You might have seen that. I will put it in the end card of this video so you can check that video. It's an old school video. It would be cool if you could check it out and watch it and let me know what you think about my flank steak roast. We have preheated the gas grill on full power and we are now grilling our flank steaks several minutes on direct heat from both sides first. That's the first side, the second side. And then we have to keep the other parts of the steak in mind and sear them as well. We are headed for an internal temperature of approximately 52 degrees Celsius, which is medium rare, approximately 85 degrees Fahrenheit, something in that area. Of course, if you are making videos with steaks, you won't meet every viewer's taste. A lot of people are more into medium, some are into blue. I like something in between. So that's the other part of the Flank steaks rolls we have to grill as well. If you cut them in the right size, they will stand up that way. And once we are ready grilling it from this side, we're gonna put them on indirect heat and let them rest there until they have the internal temperature we are headed for. So here's the result. One of the flank steaks rolls is ready, and the moment you cut, you see that there still is the rub in between, and that's exactly what we are looking for. It's the aim, or it's the goal, to have a nice flavor of that barbecue rub still inside the steak. And of course, I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Please make sure to hit that like button and leave me a comment if you have any experiences with barbecue rub on beef, which is not quite common. Please make sure to visit my fan pages, Instagram, Facebook and Patreon. It's fun there. I will put links into the video description. We're seeing us again in the upcoming days. Thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.